Hi everyone, I'm Caitlin Howe for the World Poker Tour's Royal Flush Crew in my very own hometown of San Antonio, Texas. Today, I'm here catching up with Nate Russler, one of the six remaining players in the WPT Borgata Winter Poker Open Final Table. All right, Nathan, thank you so much for making some time to speak with me today. I'm so excited to be back in the city that I was born in. And I know that you moved here from Michigan. So tell me a little bit about your journey to get to San Antonio and what you've been up to.
It was a Vegas trip, and I met the most beautiful woman that I could ever find. She was born and raised here, and just came down and haven't looked back.
So what are some of the things that you like to do when you're not grinding on the poker tables?
Exercise, play a little golf, hang out with the family, mostly. Try to keep it low-key.
And how did you get into poker to begin with?
My brother actually introduced me to the game in high school. I just loved it. I'd taken all my poker books to class and almost failed out of high school because of it, and I just kept going from there.
So I spoke to you before we met up, and you mentioned you have just entered a chapter of self-discovery. So tell me a little bit about that.
I guess it started with going through a deep depression throughout my 20s, and then trying to seek help through different avenues. And I found a lot of things through social media, which had expanded to trying psychedelics and just different ways of trying to just reshape my thoughts and thinking and feeling.
With all of that self-work, how do you think that's affected your approach to poker? Has it helped you?
Oh, absolutely. One way to shift your way is to just be thankful for the things that you have from there as a starting point. And then
you might end up at a final table.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. So I've been playing poker for close to 10 years, mostly cash games, private games. Nobody's ever heard of me. I've just been trying to figure out life through there. And then I've been having this like burning desire to start moving into the tournament realm and kind of showing my face and trying to see how far I can go through that. And I was given an opportunity by a friend of mine. He basically came to me and just said he wanted to invest in me and just kind of go with me and awesome. Yeah, push me through my dreams. So the WPT Borgata was our first stop.
Incredible. Yeah. Well, amazing job. That's yeah. So exciting. And now you're going to go play on a televised final table in Vegas.
Big stage, yeah.
What are you most excited for the final table? The glory or the prize money or
yeah, I guess
the experience?
A little bit of everything, yeah. I think it just kind of puts a bow on all of it, on all the hard work that I've kind of put into and to get some sort of recognition, because I've had a lot of people throughout my life kind of be like, you know, what are you doing? You know, where are you going? Or, you know, why are you playing poker? Because the way that I've gone, nobody knows anything about me or what I do on a day-to-day basis. So to kind of put it out there to show that good things are possible and are coming, that, I don't know, it's just
right
nice
on.
To, yeah, yeah.
Well, thank you so much for spending some of your day with me, sharing your story with all of us. We're so excited for you.